Ahoy there, Legion! During your time carving a path of wanton destruction through the Wasteland, you probably leveled up once or twice. The new perk system can be a bit daunting to a Vault Dweller whose brain was flash frozen for 200 years. Cryogenics are a tricky thing which can easily have side effects if done improperly. You might be decimating raiders in only a bathrobe for all we know. Not that there's anything wrong with that. I'm more of a fan of preventing death via power armor, but to each their own. Today we'll take a look at this jumble of a perk system and then provide you some building suggestions if you were looking for additional tips or hints on where you might want to go with it. Okay, so we got this top row of special stats, and under them are a whole bunch of perks in seemingly random order. Many of them look like ghosts, some are animated, some aren't, there's a stats and level requirement. It's a bit of a barrage to the noggin at first and a huge departure from Fallout 3. Luckily, it's not actually too rough once you get the basics. At the top, you'll notice the special stats, and this is actually the blueprint for everything else. Depending on how many points you have in each stat determines how far down this chart you can go. You can even spend your level up points on these very stats instead of a perk to unlock more options below. Due to mental conditioning from previous games, you might think you need to wait to put a point in the second row of perks until level 2, but actually the only thing you need to worry about at first is if your special is high enough. So if a perk is colored in and doesn't look like just an outline of something, you can put a point in it right away. The odd thing there is, you could, in theory, at level 1 put a point in the very bottom. This is the part that trips up most folks. Again, the only thing you need to worry about at first is your special amount. I say at first because after you've unlocked the ability, you can pump it up further with more skill points, so I can turn this 20% pistol damage into 40. But now they've added a level requirement to it as well. See there? Now you need the right special stat and be of high enough level. So even if you jump all the way to the bottom right away, they prevent you from being too overpowered by preventing you from upgrading it too soon. You might be thinking, but psycho, I just unlocked the bottom of the perk chart right away. I am the Wasteland. Well, Legion, that might be the case, but only for a little while. You just spent all your free points to unlock one perk and left everything else weak because of it. You won't be able to access locked off areas with great loot, or even be able to upgrade your weapons after a certain point. So you will get a head start, but it'll catch up with you. The ultimate dilemma for character builds is, do you want to unlock perks faster, or should you get a few early ones to make future perks easier to get? Because if you go full on special stat crazy, you're gonna have no direct bonuses from perks, and the fights can get tough in a hurry. The decision's ultimately yours, but I'd suggest a fairly balanced build to start out with. A few perks from the top rows for protection, then bump up special to reach whatever you're aiming at. If you honestly don't know what you even want, just scan the perks from bottom to top until something gets your attention. Get a few of those going, and set out to put points in them to unlock it. Bonus for all those who made it this far, if you go back to the baby's room of your now busted up house, locate the special book on the floor. Pick it up, and boom! Free stat point for you, courtesy of old Uncle Psycho. Hopefully this guide helped you out and possibly put a smile on your face. We do have another one about power armor you might like, so we'll put a link to that on the side of the screen there. If you liked this guide, we'd be honored if you would like, favorite, and share it with your buds, as that really helps us out. Of course, if you have any questions or suggestions of your own, feel free to leave a comment below. Thank you for watching, and catch you next time, Legion. Take care.